God bless you. God bless you. Listen, it is Bible study time. We get a chance to dig in the Word of God, learn some things that we may not know, or affirm some things that we already have on the inside of us, but we want to push it out a little bit more. Listen, I'm excited. I'm grateful and thankful that you are watching this video right now. Listen, before we begin, let's pray. Father, thank you. Father, we love you. We give you the glory, the honor, and we give you the praise. You have been amazing, and we thank you so much for all the things that you are doing. Bless us at this time. Bless us in this space. Whoever has pressed play, touch them, bless them, and keep them. In your son Jesus' name we pray. Thank God and amen. Man, we get a chance to dig into the Word of God a little bit more. Past few times, we've been dealing with the prayer watches. We've been talking about the eight types of prayer watches. The eight prayer watches go over a 24-hour time frame, three-hour increments, and trying to know where we are. And I think and I believe that I've heard from a few people personally that they have been blessed by it. So I'm thankful for the start of this thing into how it's unfolding right now, because everybody can talk to God. All right. You can talk to God. I don't care who you are. I don't care where you have gone. You can talk to God. And so I want you to do that. Say that to yourself. Write a note. Some people might have an issue typing in the comments. But if you can, just say, I can talk to God. All right. The eighth watch is where we're at. The eighth watch. This is the watch where we get an opportunity to pray in between 3 p.m., 3 in the afternoon, to 6 p.m., all right? I'm looking at my notes and all that good stuff. So 3 p.m. To 6 p.m. And so this is this hour of dying to self. This is an hour of rejoicing in the power of Jesus Christ. This is the hour, I want to call it the transformation time. This is that transformation time. This is typically, I believe that if you are working that typical 9 to 5 or that 9 to 6 or 8 to 6, whatever that particular time frame is, this is when you're almost about to get off. All right. This is that time that we're praying for change. We want certain changes to happen during this time. And so as I was taking a look at a few different things, I know this, and I want you to be aware of this as well, that this was the time about when Jesus died on the cross. During this particular watch, this is when he died on the cross. And so he took the sins of man, right, so that we can be reconciled to God through his blood. And so those who have accepted him as Lord and personal Savior can now live a triumphant life. We can live a victorious life through him, and we are allowed to come boldly to the throne. All right. And so he has died for us. And as a matter of fact, Apostle Paul had a great scripture. I want us to go there. Galatians chapter 2 and verse number 20. I'm going to do it in the New International Version. Galatians 2. In verse number 20, it says, I have been crucified with Christ, and I no longer live, but Christ lives in me. Y'all see that? Y'all hear that? The life I live in the body, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. That's where we're at. The life that we have. I'm so excited that all authority was given unto Jesus. He took back all of the keys. He took back everything that's needed to happen, because this was the time he's reconciling us, getting us back to the place that we need to be in. And so I'm grateful about this transformation time, this transformation watch, this time of transforming during this particular watch. I want to let you know that the one single most important characteristic or practice that really identifies the church itself is prayer. Prayer. This is a privilege that we carry. This is an opportunity that we carry. And the most important privilege of the entire church is prayer. and the hour that we're dealing with in the Bible right now on this particular time is that 3 p.m. This is when that prayer watch happens at 3 p.m. Like I told you that most of us are getting this pull at a certain time of the day to pray. We get in this pull of a certain time that we have to dig in, or we feel some type of spiritual thing, some type of little tug of war, this little struggle. We feel something on the inside. And I want to encourage you that this is your time that you pray. This is the time that has been assigned to your life. This is where that tug happens, and you can do it. All right. You can definitely do it. And so this hour it's time for us to remove limiting factors. This is the hour of prayer. This is the hour of covenant. This is the hour of power. This is the hour of triumphant glory. This is that hour of grace. We can help remove things, because during this time we see Jesus die, right? So Jesus removed veils from the temple. We heard the voice of the Lord. This is the time that it's time to die to the world, that we die to ourselves and we allow God to help us. This is the time where we can also seek the truth, all right, in God. We can seek the Lord in truth, okay? This is the hour that's established. This is where righteousness and justice has been the foundation. All right. This is that wonderful time of evening sacrifice. All right. This is what we sacrifice. We put it all out there. 3 o'clock is a very nice particular time, because as a matter of fact, they go to Acts chapter three, Peter and John is in here, and some great things happen because this is when we go to prayer. So this is their time, but not only was it time for them to pray, but it was a time for them to pour as well, so God can get the glory. So in Acts chapter 3, verse number 1, it says, one day Peter and John were going up to the temple at the time of prayer at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Now, if you continue on, I'm gonna let you read that, because there was a crippled man there and he asked them for alms. He asked them for some money. And the guys, Peter and John, say, look at us. Look at us. We some broke preachers, all right? We won't have nothing for you, but such as we have, we gonna give it to you. And they had a nerve to say, rise up, take up your bed and walk. They let them know. This guy went jumping, y'all. He went jumping. He was walking. He was healed. And they understood that there was a time that the miraculous healings of God, the angelic visitations of God, can happen during this time. Now, there's a few other scriptures in the Word of God, actually more than a few, that talk about this 3 o'clock hour where the great things happen around that time. But I want you to know that the times in history changed around this time as well. This is where we start to pray. Like the Galatians 2:20, this is when we give ourselves completely to God, and ask him to use us, ask him to make us well, ask him to let you know and to experience being free. All right. Under his mercy and under his grace and under his favor. This is where we get to thank God that he made us for who we are. And we can ask him, hey, listen, you've begun a good work. You're transforming lives. You're transforming my life. And so one of the biggest testimonies that we can have is when we tell other people that God changed our life. So then when we tie it all together, we can really ask the Lord over and over again to do something specific, do something great, do something where we are asking God to bless us, asking God to change some things. And I don't know about you, more importantly around this time, and I didn't say it in the beginning because I want to close it out like this, that this is the time where Jesus said, it is finished. This is that hour that he gave up the ghost. They didn't kill him, but he gave up his life. He gave up the ghost. He went through 6 hours of suffering. He went through some hardness. He made sure that he went through all that he needed to go through in order for deliverance to take place for this entire world. That means me and you, that he took our place. And so during this time, this is a time when you can pray for deliverance. I don't know if you've been up all night, or I don't know if you've been up all night and you've been worried about something, because at that particular time, that's our time that we can process at night and we can process during that time. But when we get into a wonderful realness, a wonderful place, and God says, pray, and he puts it in your heart and puts it in your mind for you to pray, this is the time when you can ask the Lord, say, hey, I need you to visit me. I need you to visit my son. I need you to visit my daughter. I need you to visit my family. Visit my job. I want you to touch us. I want you to transform us. And so we have to make sure that we're praying, not just for family, not just for government, not just for the economy, but we also pray that we recognize that sin has been taken over. You are no longer a slave to sin, but God has set you free from every last bit of that. So this is that transformation time. So if you're pulling that tug, you're pulling it, if you have that tug within you, you have that tug within your spirit, you start praying over and over again that God will continue to complete the work that's on the inside of us. You pray for the good purposes. You pray and be thankful that sin has no power over you because you're no longer tied to the law. You pray that you can be a tool that's being used for God. You pray over and over again that God will complete the work that he has put on the inside of us and he has put on our church. And so I want you to know that that's the way you specifically identify yourself, is when you pray, there is nothing impossible for God. I'm telling you, when you talk to him and give it to him, God can work it out. Listen, that's my time. That's our eighth watch. I'll come up with something. We'll be back with what the Lord says at another time. But thank you for coming to this virtual space. Listen, I want you to be well. I want you to be whole. I want you to be healed. That's what I'm praying for myself. And I just want to project that on you as well. Listen, as I say times before, listen, do not stop praying. Don't stop praying. All right. Please don't stop. God has a great work on the inside of you. We're going to close it with prayer. Father, we love you. Father, we thank you. Bless us, touch us, transform us. In Jesus' name we pray. We say thank God and we say amen. As I said before, listen, don't stop praying. Don't you stop praying. And please do not stop praying. Y'all have an amazing day.